Hello and welcome to another Typhoon HIL tutorial in which we'll show you new features of our control center inspired entirely by your feedback. The first thing you can notice is that the home screen can't be resized anymore. That is because all our tools are now running in separate windows. Moreover, they are running as separate processes, which makes it possible to better utilize multi-core processors. The result is a more responsive user interface and less user interface interlocking. Also, the multi-window concept fits perfectly to multi-screen setups, which is quite useful for complex models and for complex test scenarios. Another very obvious novelty is that HIL control panel is now replaced with HIL SCADA, which is what we will mostly focus on in this tutorial. So, let's start as always with Schematic Editor. As I mentioned, it opens in its own window. The first thing you notice is a new welcome screen. It offers direct links to your recently opened schematic files, which you can open with a single click. On top of that, it also gives you a direct link to our example model folder, which we'll open right now. So, I'm going to open a model of a grid-connected converter. For your reference, the path to this model is now shown on the screen. In Schematic Editor, there are many changes under the hood. Most of them are focused on performance optimization. For example, we significantly shortened model loading time and model validation time in 2017.1 release. And this is especially noticeable with large, complex models. Now, our model has been opened, and this is our standard example model, so I'll just quickly give you some key details about it. What we have here is a two-level, three-phase inverter with a DC source on the DC side. And on the AC side, we have an ideal voltage source with switchable impedance and an EMI filter in between. The converter is internally controlled, meaning that all the controls are implemented inside the model, and we are also using our built-in PWM modulator. So, let's compile and load the model. Like before, you still have the compile command which will compile the model. Once the compilation is finished, our software is going to automatically invoke HIL SCADA, which now replaces our old HIL control panel, and it will automatically load the model, either to our hardware unit or to our virtual device. While the model is being compiled, let me draw your attention to the fact that everything is still seamlessly integrated. Although each tool now runs in a separate process and in a separate window, they are still connected, and, for example, Schematic Editor can invoke HIL SCADA the same way that it used to invoke HIL control panel in our earlier software releases. As you can see at the bottom of the window, our model utilizes only a single core of our FPGA solver, and it also has a certain number of signal processing elements which are going to be compiled to run on our ARM processors. So, model compilation is done. And here we are. Welcome to HIL SCADA. I'm going to load the model to a virtual device since I have no HIL device connected to my laptop. Now my virtual device is being built and in a moment I will be able to run the model. While our model is loading, we can immediately notice that HIL SCADA screen layout is significantly different from HIL control panel. Actually, HIL SCADA is built on our custom UI concept. But here, the concept has been taken to another level. As you can see, the welcome screen is also changed and is very similar to the new welcome screen of Schematic Editor. You can immediately load recently opened panels, and you can open panel files located in the model directory with a single click. Everything in HIL SCADA is built around the panel. The panel is what you use to control and monitor the model and the simulation. Another important thing to notice is that there is a single tab. We no longer have separate tabs for simulation control, for capture and scope, and for custom UI. So, while you're running the simulation, Now there is no need to constantly switch among different tabs. As you can see, this resembles our old custom UI, but there are way more functions available here. For example, you can now run multiple panels. In addition to this panel, I can now create another panel, which I can run alongside this one. It is important to emphasize that only one panel can be active at a time. You can activate a panel by simply right-clicking a tab and selecting the option Set Active. A huge time-saving benefit of multiple tabs is that there is no longer just one way to add widgets to the panel. Instead of having to add widgets directly from a library, now you can also copy widgets from another panel or from multiple panels. Another feature that was missing and is now available is the full undo-redo stack. This means that you can easily go back and forth through actions which are saved in our history view. Another nice feature is that we can now zoom in and zoom out in our HIL SCADA panel. This makes panels much more suitable for large models and for huge numbers of widgets. Yet another feature that can help if you need more space to interact with your model is the new full screen mode. If you press the full screen button or you press F11, the active panel is switched to the full screen. This mode is very useful when you don't want to change anything in your model but you just want to interact with it. Of course, you can switch back by pressing F11 again. At this point, some of you may be wondering where you can find old control panel functions. For example, what if you want to change a dynamic parameter? Or if you want to change the state of a contactor? Or you want to change the scale of the analog output? In the previous software versions, you used to do these things in Simulation Control tab. All these functionalities are now available on the right-hand side of HIL SCADA in the Model Settings panel. Of course, HIL SCADA is fully customizable, so you can also move this to the left-hand side and have it there together with the Library panel or maybe under it. So, it is in Model Settings where you can change, for example, the source parameters, where you can override the contactor control, where you can assign signals to, say, analog outputs or digital outputs, and so on. Yet another nice feature is that all dynamic elements are shown in a tree view that follows the schematic hierarchy. So, you can easily access and filter out elements only on a given level or on given levels of the model. This is best exemplified by SCADA inputs. For example, you can select just this subsystem and you will be shown only the active elements available on that level of hierarchy and everything below. You can also select a single control element. Or you can even filter elements by typing a couple of letters of their name. In short, there are now many ways that make it easy to navigate through large models. On the left-hand side, there is a library browser, identical to the one we had in Custom UI. However, next to the library, there is another novelty, Panel Explorer. It's very helpful when you are navigating complex panels. So, even if you have a very complex, multi-layered panel, it is easy to find a component or the widget by clicking on it, and it will be highlighted in the panel, and you can then even change its properties directly from Panel Explorer, without a need to dig deep into the sub-layers of your panel. So, let's now start the simulation. We have our panel set and we just click to start the simulation and we can see that our model seems to be running just fine on our virtual device. We can see the expected value for our DC voltage, the expected value for our AC line-to-line voltage, as well as the RMS current. So, let's also check the power output of our converter. You can see that it is in accordance with the set point that we provided. You can also observe the behavior of the converter if you change those references, which I'm doing right now. And yes, it responds as expected to set point changes. But what if you want to dig a little bit deeper in the details? What if you want to see your signals in time? In previous software releases, this was something that you observed in our Capture and Scope tab of HIL Control Center. In HIL SCADA, Scope is just another widget that you can drag and drop to a panel. In this panel, Scope is already placed, and you can see that it is a part of this panel. It is very important to notice that because Scope is now a part of a panel, all Scope settings are now saved in the panel file instead of the model settings file. Of course, it goes without saying that backward compatibility is fully preserved. If you load an old settings file that holds Capture Scope settings, you can apply those settings to the new Capture Scope widget, which is, as I said, now part of a panel. If you double-click the Capture Scope widget, a separate Capture Scope window appears, which you are probably quite familiar with, of course if you use our previous versions of software. However, Capture Scope is not only a HIL SCADA widget now, it is also significantly improved. This means that user interface is much more streamlined now. For example, if you click Signals, you can see that you can now select signals and allocate them to any viewport in a single step. Moreover, it is fully interactive. As you're selecting, you can directly plot new values. In addition to these user interface changes, we also significantly improved the performance of Capture and Scope. It is now way more responsive, especially for large numbers of signals and for large datasets. Actually, let me show you that. Let's put Capture Scope in the full screen mode and let's switch to the capture function. As you can see, we are about to capture 16 signals. Moreover, we are going to capture them at the full simulation rate. Let's capture 2 seconds of data. With parameters set like this, we are going to capture 2 mega samples per channel. With 16 channels of data, we are expected to get around 32 mega samples of data. I'm going to force trigger now. Now we are capturing data from the simulation and then we are transferring data to capture and displaying it. You can immediately see that it is running much faster than previously. Zooming in and moving through the captured data is also much faster now. It is safe to say that the new capture tool is at least 10 times faster and more responsive than the old one, especially with large numbers of signals. Another nice feature of the new Capture Scope is that you can run it in 2 different modes. The mode in which it is running right now is called the window mode. This means that Scope is running in a separate window and you have a button which you click to invoke that window in the panel. However, now you can also embed Scope inside a panel. In other words, the full Scope window can now also be a widget inside the panel. To do that, you right-click the Scope button and choose the option to switch it to the embedded mode. Now you have Scope as a part of the panel. You can move it around, you can scale it like any other part of the panel. In short, Scope is now really just a standard embedded widget in HIL SCADA. As you have just seen, it is very easy and very quick to switch between the window mode and the embedded mode. With this, we can conclude this video, which highlights new features in 2017.1 software release. As always, we are looking forward to your comments and suggestions. After all, these new features are based entirely on your feedback, and it is only through implementing your feedback that we can not only meet, but also exceed your expectations. Thank you for watching, and feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel to receive updates about the latest videos and tutorials.